David Faustino.
Hello, this is Andrew Chalmers, the writer and doctor in Doctor Who, Doctor.
This is Dr. Steve-o.
Everybody, this is the Cavernator.
This is Inspector Gadget.
Hey, what's cracking, y'all? It's your boy, J-Rock.
Good evening, folks. This is James Duval.
This is Jeremy Taggart.
This is Kim Possible.
I'm Chris Holden-Reed.
Hey, this is Pat Mastriani from Degrassi.
This is the evil Dr. Bad Vibes.
Again, this is Messy Bear.
And this is Mort from X-Men.
Hey, this is Andrew Gazzess.
This is Sean Gunn.
Hi, this is Robert Carradine.
It's Tammy Stronach from The Neverending Story.
Hey, it's Zach Callison.
Hey, I'm DJ Jenny Rod.
And I'm Neil Young.
I'm Commander Shepard.
Ralph Garman here. You're listening to Droids Canada. You've made an excellent choice. You have chosen wisely.
Warning. Listener discretion is advised.
That means there's a lot of fucking swearing.
Hello.
You've seen the difference, and it's getting better all the time. There's nothing you and I won't do. I'll stop the world and melt with you. We should know better.
Dream of better lives, the kind which never hate.
Do you think that we bonded together in Philadelphia?
There was definitely some bonding.
There was.
I couldn't look you straight in the eyes when I said that, though.
Why? It's because the song doesn't match the mood?
Yeah, that's true.
I'm sorry. Oh, just let me fade this one out then. So, Dan, yeah. This is like the first episode.
This is post-Philly.
And
post-Philly, first time
I know
in
Ellie's going to be mad about the fact that she's not here.
What's up, Ellie? I was trying to get him to play a little Peter Frampton, but... There you go. It's a great, great tune.
Of course it's a great tune. It's a Guess Who. So, Dan...
I don't know how to do the flick.
The...
Oh, that.
There you go.
That was it?
Jesus.
All right.
So, Dan.
Yes.
What did the Jen think about the pylon?
About the pylon? It was just a... Like, what the hell is this? And I'm like, that's a Rocky pylon.
So it's not a Rocky pylon. We just stole it from the...
from the Rocky Monument-ish area.
We may or may not have permanently borrowed a pylon from the city of Philadelphia.
We'll bring it back one day. The pylon is like Rocky. It's beaten up, but it still stands.
Hey, yo.
I did.
So what people don't understand is that...
You lost your hat.
On our last day... Full day in Philadelphia.
Yes.
We decided we want to go do the Rocky Stairs.
And see Philly.
And see Philadelphia.
Yes, exactly.
We didn't get to see much of it. We got to see enough, I think. Just to wet the palate.
Yes. So then palate wetting.
You're going to go back if you want to go back. So we did the whole Rocky Stairs after finding a good parking spot and
took
the photos.
Every Italian kid's
Dan
dream.
Ran some stairs and was pretty gassed.
That was a great moment in my life. It's the.
Did you actually play the music while you ran up the stairs?
No. No.
So what, you just recorded a video?
Yeah.
Did it ever get uploaded?
No, that was for Jen. That was for the Jen.
That should make fun of
you. Her response was, I was waiting for this. And my response was, I've been waiting for this moment my whole life.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
No problem.
Being able to do that was a very, very big thing for me.
But was it bigger than the guy who was the staff member?
Event staff.
Of the Rocky statue that doesn't actually have event staff?
Yeah, you know what? He did a good job.
I don't know. The photos I got were pretty junky.
Well, some dude just stands in front of the Rocky monument
an event staff
that
jacket.
Says event staff and takes everyone's phones and takes pictures of them and tells them to do the different poses.
Champion.
And do the champion. Back to back. You're going to fight. And he works for tips. And, yeah, like, I gave him a few bucks.
Fire while he's smoking some darts.
Yeah, he's hacking darts while he's taking photos. I think there's, like,
awesome.
A brown bag of liquid.
What are you trying to say, Dan? Feels like stereotyping.
He had a brown bag.
Maybe he wanted to keep his drink cold. Maybe it was a bottle of water.
Because a paper bag keeps a drink cold?
I don't know. Do you know physics?
It hides the bourbon.
It hides the Thunderbird.
Oh, fuck.
Wow, Dan,
It was a good time, and you know, then when we go back to the car, there's this pylon that just appears right, like pretty much touching the car. It's coming with us.
No, tell him the true story, Dan.
Yeah, I totally pussied out.
Oh, yeah, you totally did.
Like, I'm like, no, we can't. We can't. Dan, like, we're in a different country.
I'm like, Dan, we're going to just, like, you know, we'll just do, like, look out for you. No, I can't do it.
I couldn't, like, be part of it.
Just open the trunk. Okay. And he innocently goes, sits in the car.
Yeah.
So he
couldn't be part of
claim
it.
Claim ignorance. That's what made me laugh, was the fact that you did that just so you can claim ignorance. And, of course, what did he do? He opened the trunk and Emily fires it in the trunk.
It's coming home. So, yeah, no, I was like, yeah, how you drive over the border, like, anything to declare? Pylon? Slightly used?
For sure.
So yeah, that and another good point in Philly was the Philly cheesesteak from Steve's Steaks.
Apparently that's not a good place.
No? Says who?
I've just been looking...
Been researching?
I've been researching the internet.
I was told from a guy from Philly, Philly's known for two things.
And the first part is fairly accurate.
Cheesesteaks and assholes.
No, the second part's fairly accurate.
Assholes and cheesesteaks?
Because I still don't even know why the guy pulled over to yell at the other guy, because the other guy was getting out of his car. Fuck you. He's like...
Yeah, that's just regular day in Philly. And, you know, eating my cheesesteak, which I found absolutely fucking delicious... The guy walking by and yelling, finish it.
Oh, when I told you to finish it?
Yeah.
He comes over, finish it!
Like, I was, yes, sir. But yeah, no, it was a good time. It was a good time, Philly. Hail Hydra. There you go. Take it back.
Dude, who's singing that?
It's a Frank Stallone.
He's known for two things, this song and porn.
Yeah, take it back.
Oh, he wasn't, was he an episode of, he was in a movie.
Was he in Oz?
No.
He was? I think he was.
I know who you're thinking of. The guy that always... No, it's not him.
You're going to have to look that up. I think he was.
Oh, my God. I'm going to go to the internets for this.
Got to go to the interwebs.
He wasn't in fucking Oz. You think of the Italian guy that's in everything that everyone was. Hold on, wait.
Frank Stallone. Still says
okay,
no.
Google. Was Frank Stallone in Oz?
Sorry, I'm not sure how to help.
Yep, oh, that's a no.
You suck, Google. However, I do gotta give Google some props for the Thanos.
Yeah, that was actually interesting.
That was pretty awesome. That was pretty awesome. So,
was Frank Stallone in Tombstone?
Just IMDb Frank Stallone.
He really was in fucking Tombstone.
Here, I'm gonna.
He was in Tombstone. Look here. Hold on. I'll show you.
Can you zap it up to that monitor?
Yeah, you'll know the character too. Everywhere. Yeah, well...
I don't think I'd know the character because I haven't seen Tombstone.
What?
Did you IMDB him?
Is that like the knockoff brand?
IMDB? I'm not database. Was Frank Stallone in O?
O?
O,
see, you're,
no.
I know who you're thinking of, but it's not... I'm literally pressing Z. I think the Z on my keyboard died.
You broke the Z?
Oh, there it is. No, there. Z.
IMDB. IMDB.
IMDB Frank Oz?
No, oh. Not Frank Oz.
Bye.
You can see the ratings and reviews for movies and TV shows. And
yeah.
See what they say about Avengers Endgame, because that's everything right now.
Yeah,
don't click on it. You might get spoilers.
I don't even care anymore.
Spoilers.
Oh, so my God, I keep pressing...
You just typed in Frank Stallone.
No, it's because this keyboard's...
That's going to be that.
No, this
that's going to be
dying.
One of those old Sylvester Stallone videos of him lying underneath a glass table.
Oh, I didn't notice. He was in First Blood. This is the movie. What movie is this?
It's just a picture.
No, he was in a movie that they made fun of the fact that he was just... He wasn't over the top. Staying in line. He was in Hudson Hawk.
I turned my head around like a switch.
He was in Transformers?
Robots in Disguise TV series.
Doesn't matter. Oh my God, he was a garbage man.
You're scrolling so quick.
Rocky 2. Hold on. He's been in a lot of movies.
Miami Vice.
He's had a video short.
He was Billy. Oh, Billy.
He was actually in Hudson Hawk.
Oh my God, he was in The Legend.
He was in Tales of the Crypt.
Legend of the Rollerblade 7.
I don't even know what that
as
is.
The Black Knight.
I don't want to know.
And Rollerblade 7 as the Black Knight.
I'm sorry, Frank.
We're going to have to watch that one day.
The Naked Truth? No.
He's in Sybil?
No. Movie stars. He was in a movie that they made, Walker, Texas Ranger.
Walker, Texas Ranger?
One of the greatest TV shows of all time.
Two episodes.
One of the greatest TV shows of all time.
He was in Hitler's.
Oh my god. Which way is this keyboard?
Maybe he wasn't in Oz.
No, it doesn't look like he was in Oz, my friend.
You keep scrolling. I can't see.
I can't even.
My eyes are bad, though.
Yeah, you're fucking blind as a bat.
Sometimes.
Oh, he was in Rambo.
There you go. Some more tunes.
There wasn't tunes.
There wasn't tunes? What was it? Ads?
Where is my... Which
ads. One? It's ads. Gotta get that ad blocker.
Okay, here's the problem.
What's the problem?
Is that I didn't set this up correctly, so I don't know what screen is which way.
Uh-oh.
So I gotta do that. Anyways, talk to me. Talk to me, Dan. Talk to me.
Hello.
Oh, God.
Oh, what'd you do?
Oh, God.
What'd you do?
Oh, there it is. It's this way. Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna mirror it. But anyways, you gotta buy me some time. Buy me some time.
Buy some time. Mm-hmm. So, after getting home from Philly, there was a neat little incident that happened at my house.
Oh, yeah. You filled Droids Canada.
Yeah. So, what happened was about maybe 150, 200 meters from my house, there was a standoff.
An actual standoff.
In a town where nothing happens.
That's not necessarily true.
Nothing happens.
Things happen.
But
people die.
So, you know, I live in a nice little community called Font Hill. And now, what were they referring it to as? Thug Hill?
Thug Hill.
Yeah, so...
That's classic.
A great little... I don't know why I'm saying great, but... A little incident happened. Family's having a family squabble. Guns become involved.
It was a family squabble?
It was a family squabble. Started with a family squabble. Guns become involved, and this gentleman... ends up barricading himself in a house with a bunch of weapons. So SWAT teams are called, you know, because it is Font Hill, there's a great response time there. And the whole kind of subdivision gets put on lockdown.
Okay.
Is this adventure music?
No.
This is training from Rocky 3. Yes. Okay. This is when he gets back on
the... This is Ellie's favorite because the robot's in this one.
No, Rocky 4 is the...
Is that a robot? Rocky 4?
Is this 3?
Yeah. There's no easy way out.
Yeah. This is when he starts training... No.
For a Club of Rain. No, your Hearts on Fire was...
Hearts on Fire, yeah. Was 4.
Was 4.
Okay. Yeah, this is when he gets back on track. Now, speaking of back on track, I get a message while I'm at work that there's a... police disturbance in my subdivision, so I called the wife. And, oh, what's going on? Oh my god, there's cops everywhere. There's SWAT teams. Like, get the hell out of the house. You know, send her to mom's house, and you know, I come home from work and go to talk to the police, and yep, there's a standoff. There's a guy with a bunch of weapons, and our house is one in the area that's put on lockdown or evacuate. People are told to go to their basements and lock the doors, and it's a, you know, had to go to a command center, aka Sobey's parking lot, to get some info. And yeah, it was a peaceful resolution to it all. But
I was expecting more of a story.
This isn't really that much of a story when you think of it. It's just there was a, that's something that doesn't really happen around us. Well, nice little white picket fence kind of town. That kind of shit doesn't happen. So, but after hearing more about it, apparently it was an ex-military person who did that, and I hope he gets the help he needs.
I like how you just wrinkled that in at the end.
Why?
I hope he gets the help he needs.
Oh, 100%. I support the military. I support the police. I'm all for it.
Well, I thought that was the cool thing to do, is not to support the police.
No, that's why I'm against the the norm now.
I don't understand people who like to do those fucking videos of them trying to them telling the cops off.
Yeah, like if you don't like the job they're doing, then become one.
Oh, come on now.
No, legit, become one, because these people, like, it's easy to hate a cop until you need one.
Yeah, sure.
So, you know what? Respect the police. Respect what they do. Oh, there's bad ones out there. Yeah, there's bad everything out there. But for 200 good things they do, the one bad thing is the one that you hear.
I'll go ahead.
So, you know what? Support the police. Support your local police. And thank them for the job they're doing, because they're putting their lives on the line every day for us to keep my ass safe, which they did during the standoff.
Oh, Jesus Christ. All right, so you've seen Avengers Endgame. I haven't watched it yet.
Yes, I have. Hail okay. Hydra.
This news broke to yesterday. Woman reportedly hospitalized after Avengers Endgame for uncontrollable crying.
Okay.
What they are probably neglecting in this. She was sobbing uncontrollably during the film, found herself short of breath with numb hands and feet after having an anxiety attack.
Yeah,
the woman was
it.
Taken to a Chinese hospital emergency.
I don't see it.
I don't understand how that happened. What? So was she in Greensboro? Oh, a 21-year-old Chinese fan was so moved. So there's a Chinese hospital in Greensboro, North Carolina?
That's a different place down there.
Is it really?
I got lost in Greensboro.
Was it green?
It was.
Was it very thorough?
It was a... the people we met were really nice. Because we were driving to Myrtle Beach. Yeah, we were driving to Myrtle Beach. And we were going through Greensboro. And the GPS that we had was a little older. So at one point, there's new highways and we're driving through a field. We're like, where the fuck are we? So we decided to stop and grab some Subway. I love Subway.
Did Cold you cut eat Crush? Combo.
I did. I totally ate
like
Crush.
Subway.
I didn't meet Jared there.
You didn't get the footlong?
No, he's in... Well, no. Well... Yeah, I'm going to leave that one alone. And more Rocky songs?
I'm just doing my job, buddy. You keep talking.
But I just... Fuck yeah. So, yeah, it was a nice community and people gave us nice directions. They were very nice and pleasant. Oh, you're from Canada, eh? I don't know why I'm doing that in
accent.
I don't
know either. That makes two of us.
Yeah, so it was...
Makes you start questioning you as a person.
God.
Are you tired?
A little bit.
You're doing like the head nod already. We just got here.
I know.
Anyways, that's not relevant. What I'm trying to understand is why a 21-year-old woman cried uncontrollably to the point that she gave herself an anxiety attack on a fictional film.
Yeah, it is make-believe.
Fictional film.
You know what? Like,
I understand you have the argument that people were sobbing uncontrollably when they saw the movie Passion of the Christ. But that was a very deep... religious film to some.
Yes.
And I guess you could say Avengers.
To some.
I guess you could say the same to Avengers, but spoiler alert, I haven't seen the movie, but what the fuck did you think was going to happen? People die, Dan. Mark Ruffalo already spoiled it. People die.
There was a predictableness to the movie. That's not giving anything away. There was, to me, a predictableness of it.
Spoilers. God damn it, Dan.
But it was a great movie.
You know what?
And you can tell by, I've been to a number of, not as many movies as you have. You go to lots of movies. How often do you have massive audience reaction in the theater?
Right.
There was massive audience reaction. And there's certain points in the movie where you hear dead silence. And there's points in the movie where everyone is cheering. And there's points in the movie where everyone's like, holy fuck. And that was just, they kind of, I think, went through that, the whole Disney roller coaster.
Okay.
Yeah, action, sad, happy, sad. Just a complete
sounds
roller coaster.
Like, I got the clap. Okay.
Yeah, well, yeah, that is how. Oh,
whatever.
You know, happy, sad, happy, get the medication. Sad, it doesn't work. Happy, got to go to the doctor again. Sad, see people you know there. You know how it goes.
No.
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 And I've never been to a movie with as much audience reaction for what was going on. Mind you, it was the day it came out. But there was massive audience reaction. To me, that shows something of a memorable flick. Oh. And also for the fact that it was 3 hours and 2 minutes and it did not seem remotely that long. Uh-oh. But that whole sobbing uncontrollably, I call bullshit. Bullshit. You're reading something. I could see your mind just going like, what the fuck? Okay, we got a new tune on. What are you doing?
STD.
There we go.
Happen to you.
What is this?
Happen to me.
Is this
STDs
song? Who is this? Where did you find this?
Kind of annoying.
STDs can be kind of annoying.
I'm sure it's about to get worse. Here it is.
Herpes.
Oh, God.
Do you want worse?
tell me who this is.
Do you want warts on your rectum?
Not all STDs are this bad.
Who is this?
You can't correct them.
This is killing me.
I'm coming around the other side of the booth to see who the fuck this is.
Oh, chlamydia.
Do you want discharge?
Pie and putter.
Do you want discharge?
It's done by pie and buttered soup.
Vaginal burning. It's really gross.
Oh, it gets worse.
Trust me, I've seen it. STDs happen to you, happen to me.
STDs,
they can be.
Suppose for 14,000 views.
How many?
14,000. Still a minute left.
Okay, is this on iTunes?
It's on YouTube.
Okay, I gotta see if it's on iTunes.
Do you want a PID?
Is this they're called pie and butter soup?
Let me scroll.
Oh God.
Infertility.
Pie and buttered soup.
Buttered.
Buttered.
Okay.
Syphilis.
Oh God.
You're gonna get quite an infection.
At least I know the name of the episode.
Pie and buttered soup.
You'll get the flu. That's why you should.
No results for pie and buttered soup. What is the song called?
STD song.
Okay.
I just thought I'd just break the ice a little. I just thought there's like more. Hold on. There's like a list.
So
hold on. Wait. There's one called Dr. Evil No STD. Like what can potentially go wrong?
So.
Time today, it's okay. Kind of sticky to be going around without a condom. It's kind of gross.
Not even remotely close to pie and buttered soup.
Burning and itch. There's a song called Burning and Itching.
So, good old
reindeer STD.
Good old Apple iTunes. I type in STD song. What comes up? Shallow from Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper.
There's actually an STD song done by the UMD Health Center. I'm very tempted.
Okay.
It's happening.
No.
It's happening.
Oh.
Oh my God, he's... Hold on. You have to watch this video with me.
Oh, Jesus.
He's wearing a giant condom.
Yep.
Nice guitar, though.
Syphilis, chlamydia, HPV, and gonorrhea. Everybody.
Why are they so fucking happy?
STD. I like how the big guys.
Except
got
for the guy
HIV.
With the HIV, the high five, yeah.
Why has he got a giant fro?
People get from unprotected sex. Everybody loves their STDs.
What? No, no.
You might think that. Everything is wonderful.
This is awesome because you can see every one of them as a little bit embarrassed.
Where they've been before.
They're trying to figure out how they were talked into this.
Yeah, they're like, they're all feeling a little bit shame except for the guy playing the guitar.
While your thing's erect,
this is his big break. This is the song
just what you
that's going to make him go over.
See, this one is Douche Chills. I know you never play the same song again, but can you please go back to Pie and Buttered Soup?
No.
Loves their STDs.
See, I didn't get to see their video.
There's no video. It's just lyrics on a screen.
People try, but Jesus. They don't know that sometimes symptoms don't show. Say hello to all your STDs.
I want to punch that guy singing.
The song. It's the most important verse of the song.
All right.
It's the difference between life.
Let's segue off this topic.
Okay. Pie and buttered soup.
We have to segue onto another
How old was that video of pie and buttered soup?
Oh, I don't know. I can double check in a minute, but I don't remember. We have to move on to a new topic.
Okay. Oh, Jesus Christ. Are you caught up?
I am.
Who's going to die this week? Not Peter Dinklage. He will not die.
I was actually watching Pickles the other day. The movie is so bad, but Peter Dinklage is in it. It makes it good.
Pickles.
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 Anyways, the first episode was better than the second episode, in my opinion. The second episode was more the emotional heartstring episode.
Yes, it was the emotional heartstring episode to get you to...
Oh, I got a meme for you.
To bring you back to your favorite characters before they get massacred.
You know, that whole scene at the end of the first episode when Jamie shows up and Bran's staring at him.
The holy fuck, yeah.
You know, he wasn't pissed about being pushed out a window. Did you see any fucking ramps? Like, did you see any way for him to get that?
That's true. He's just kind of hanging out in the courtyard because that's the only place he can go.
So this meme pretty much solves pretty much everything that could have happened.
Yeah, pretty much.
I thought it was a good episode. The second episode was, like I said, more the heart emotional high strings. They're pretty much,
yeah, I
as
did.
Dan would say, the emotional setting the table.
Setting the table.
Because you know next episode has at least three character deaths.
Well, I'm going to say two specific. I'm calling the death of Brienne.
I don't know about Brienne. That. That's kind of
I think
bold.
Because... Brienne got knighted, so
yeah,
I honestly...
Yeah, but Tormund didn't give her the good old giant's bane.
Yeah, and I think Tormund's going to die alongside of her.
I don't know about that.
Yeah, I think Brienne and Tormund are going to be done. And I think another side character of Davos, I think he's going to be done.
Sir Davos?
Sir Davos.
Nah, he's got a good record of surviving everything.
How are they going to tie back in?
Oh my god, there's an actual video of him listening to his song.
Of listening to the STD song?
No.
Oh, the Peter Dinklage song.
It's Peter Dinklage. Let's okay. do the Peter Dinklage song. I must hear it now.
All right.
Hold on.
Cue song.
Have you heard your theme song?
No.
Oh, okay. This is from YouTube.
Oh, boy.
And I feel like you're really going to enjoy your theme song.
Wow.
Oh, setup is stupid.
Dinklage, Peter Dinklage, Peter Dinklage, Peter Dinklage.
And it's all... Wow. That guy has to come up with better lyrics. Wow.
Is that the weirdest thing a fan has made for you?
That's quite strange, but, you know, he's got to, like, you know, tap into his inner John Lennon or something and come up with some more lyrics.
You should comment that on the video.
Oh, that wasn't me. That wasn't me. That wasn't me.
All right. And that was for, okay.
Anyways.
Richard Ashcroft called and wants his haircut back.
Apparently.
There's an STD rap. Oh, there's a rap. Nice.
Oh, no. Yeah.
What is this song?
It's the OPP song.
Yeah, okay.
There's been a lot of questions.
Oh, God.
You know.
Why are we listening to songs about OPP?
Yeah, only education.
I have to ask, why are we watching videos about STDs?
Because it's...
We're supposed to talk about Philadelphia, Dan.
We discussed this earlier.
I think this is how we're going to end the show.
We topic for like a minute and then this.
We're horrible people. Oh my god.
An abstinence.
Let's go. STDs, time to explain them. I'll take it frame by frame them. And coming up with this rap so you can name them. S is for sexually, T is for transmitted. D is for disease.
This guy's got no rap game at all.
You need to know your status, something you cannot forgo. Like your Facebook
profile. Sound horrible, but you can tell how white he is.
Yep.
Like, it's bad.
Perfect protection is abstinence.
He's got no rhythm at all.
Like, I smell mayonnaise. That's how white this is.
Let's discuss the criteria.
Bacteria
and critters can be cured. Viruses cannot
be Gracious bastard.
Rest assured, there's
mass-reduced
side effects. Better yet, use latex condoms for safer sex.
If it's omitted, okay, you're very how about the 12 STIs of Christmas?
Dice, you must what? Stay committed. What? Where's that?
3 down.
Oh my god, okay, fair enough.
Yeah, it's going to be way better than the rap.
On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a bug that made it hard to pee.
Oh, who does it this for Christmas episode?
On the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me chlamydia and a chance of infertility.
Yes.
On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me syphilis, chlamydia, and my testicles are sore and lumpy.
Ooh.
On the fourth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me genital herpes, syphilis, chlamydia, and the discharge which is hourly.
Ooh.
On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me
look at the little cartoons underneath.
Gonorrhea. Genital herpes, syphilis, chlamydia, and the possibility of HIV. On the sixth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me pubic lice, gonorrhea, genital herpes, syphilis,
oh my God,
chlamydia,
I have no words.
And an infection that was urinary.
How the fuck did we start this?
On the seventh day of Christmas, my true love gave to me hepatitis, pubic lice, gonorrhea.
Oh, it gets worse. You're like, it can't get worse. And somehow it got worse. Sit down, Nick. You know, when this is done, I'm just going to wrap up this episode. Because there's no way of saving this episode. Oh my God. Syphilis, chlamydia, and my groin itches constantly.
Oh my God.
On the ninth day of Christmas, my true love gave
here we go.
Genital warts, trichomoniasis, hepatitis, pubic lice, gonorrhea.
Well done.
Genital herpes, syphilis, chlamydia, and sore the thread anally.
Oh my God.
On the tenth day of
I would just die if that was
the case.
Look
at the pictures.
Baby's genital warts, trichomoniasis, hepatitis, pubic lice,
what is CBs?
Gonorrhea.
I don't even know where to see that. Oh, scabies.
It was a tenth day.
Scabies.
Oh, scabies.
Wearing
okay.
Pants with some difficulty.
Ooh.
On the 11th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me pelvic inflammatory disease, scabies, genital warts, trichomoniasis, hepatitis, pubic lice, gonorrhea.
It's just, oh no, our day to go.
Syphilis, chlamydia, and I no longer feel horny.
Oh God, no.
On the 12th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me dose of the crabs, pelvic inflammatory disease.
Isn't dose of the crabs also pubic lice?
I've never had the problem, down.
Pubic lice, gonorrhea.
That moment when you realize you fucked up.
Is this where we wrap
genital
it up?
Herpes, syphilis, chlamydia, and no one will make love to me.
That's how I'm ending it. We literally got nothing done in this episode.
Yeah.
I think we're just better off just moving on to the next thing and hoping for the best.
Yeah, fingers crossed.
All right, go ahead.
Bye-bye.